today what we're going to be doing is starting the teardown to replace the top end for the YZ250F. So this is just going to be part one of the top end rebuild for this engine. And we're basically just going to be taking off the valve cover, taking out the cams, taking off the cylinder, and removing the piston and inspecting some of the bottom end components to see where this engine sits. Alright guys, this is the engine here. I've went ahead and just cleaned up some of the loose debris that's been sitting around it, so that way we can minimize the amount of dirt that was exposed to the cylinder. So we're just going to start by taking off these two bolts here and this breathing hose, and that'll give us access to the cams and the cylinder head bolts. This is the locating clip right here. It sits in the groove of the bearing for the camshaft. You don't want to lose this clip. So right now I've just got this piece of safety wire. I'm actually going to tie up the cam chain so it doesn't fall into the case. Just in case of a emergency. So next what we're going to do is we're going to remove the tension from the chain. So this is the cam chain tensioner here. You're going to need a 10 mil and an 8 mil and a flat top screwdriver to back out the tensioner. So inside there's a little groove in this hole here. And you can get your screwdriver in there, feel the groove, and you can rotate it to take the tension off the cam chain. So you can see it's as reduced as possible now, and you can see the extra movement there. So it is clockwise. You just want to hold it there, and then while you're holding it, you can use your 8 mil. And remove it like so. Just so you can visualize it, here's the tensioner and the screwdriver. I'm just going to rotate it clockwise, and you can see it's falling backwards into the adjuster, and it's spring loaded, so that's what automatically adjusts the tension of the chain. There's the second one. That's not gonna want. Next, we're gonna remove these bolts, these banjo bolts holding on this hard oil line, and that'll be one less thing holding us back from taking off this cylinder head. Now you want to be careful with these because, as you can see here, because these have fluid traveling through them, there is two copper crush washers, one on each side for all three, so that's a total of six. You don't want to lose those. It won't seal properly without them. So next, I'm going to remove these two bolts here that are holding the cylinder on the side, and then there's the other four main cylinder head bolts. Alright, to loosen these cylinder head studs, we're gonna break them loose with a breaker bar, and we're gonna do it in a crisscross pattern, of course. Alright guys, so for these cylinder head bolts, there is washers inside. You're going to want to use a magnet just to double check and make sure you get those washers out. There's one. And the second one. Alright guys, so now that everything's free, we can go ahead and remove the cylinder head. As you can see here, only one of the locating pins stayed in the cylinder, so we're just going to pull that out to keep the two of them together. Alright guys, you can see here, this is one little bolt that holds on the cylinder other than the four main studs. So that is actually an 8mm, and we're just going to pop it off. Alright guys, so next we're going to remove the circlip from the wrist pin that holds the piston to the connecting rod. I put a little bit of shop towel down in the case just to prevent the clip from falling down there. Alright, so I managed to start it with these circlip pliers, but unfortunately they're not a great pair of pliers, so I finished it off just with a set of needle nose. Alright, now we're just going to push the wrist pin through and we should be able to take the piston off. There's a lot of carbon deposit on that. Alright guys, now that we have the piston off, we can kind of evaluate the bottom end of the engine a little bit just to see how things are doing. So the first thing I'm going to check for is up and down movement in the connecting rod. And on this crank, I can't feel anything. The next thing I'm going to look for is a discoloration in the crank. And you'll see a little bit here around the connecting rod. And now sometimes what that is when they build the cranks, they actually heat treat the crankshaft to just to further reinforce that bond. All right guys, that's gonna do it for this video. We've got everything taken down. We'll just wait for a few parts to show up. Hopefully they'll be here in a few days. And then we can work on the second half for this top end build. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe, and also check out my Instagram @selectmx with 2 T's. Thanks.